the rules of procedure. The debate is now adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Secretary for Financial Services and the Treasury. President, I move the second reading of the Inland Revenue Amendment No. 3 Bill 2015. The bill for short. The bill seeks to enhance the tax appeal mechanism and improve the efficiency and effectiveness of the Board of Review. The Board is an independent statutory body constituted under Inland Revenue Ordinance IRO to hear and determine tax appeals lodged by taxpayers. The proposals under the bill covers the following four areas. First, to allow direct appeal to the court on a question of law. Currently, the statutory requirement for an appeal is the case stated procedure, which is time-consuming and costly and affects the capacity of the board to hear other appeals. The bill proposes to abolish the case-stated procedure such that a taxpayer or commissioner for Inland Revenue is allowed to apply to the CFI, that is the Court of First Instance Direct, for leave to appeal against the board's decision on a question of law. If the CFI grants leave to appeal, it will hear and determine the appeal. The bill also proposes to keep the existing arrangement of leapfrog arrangement, except that the requirement for case stated will be replaced by that for leave to appeal. We've set out in the bill the procedure for application for leave to appeal of the CFI and the Court of Appeal CA. We have consulted the judiciary and comments and suggestions from the judiciary in relation to the court procedures have been incorporated. Second, empowering the board to issue directions and to sanction non-compliance. From time to time, there are late submissions of documents and information for the board's hearing. This leads to deferrals and unnecessary lengthening of hearings. With reference to the approach commonly adopted by other statutory appeal boards, we propose to empower the person presiding at the hearing to give directions on the provision of documents and information for the hearing of an appeal, and to refuse to admit any documents and information as evidence in the hearing of an appeal if they are not produced in compliance with the directions given. In order to avoid undermining a party's right to a fair hearing, the bill provides a channel for the party in default to apply to the presiding person for relief from sanction. Third, providing privileges and immunities . Unlike other statutory appeal boards, the IRO does not provide privileges and immunities to parties in a hearing. In line with the arrangement of other statutory appeal boards, we propose to provide in the ordinance that the chairman, members and deputy chairmen and other members of the board, as well as parties to a hearing performing their duties under the IRO, the same privilege and immunities to enhance protection of the operation of the board and the right of parties to the appeal. Fourth, strengthening deterrent effect against frivolous tax appeal. The board is empowered to order the appellant to pay a sum as costs. The current ceiling, 5,000, has not been adjusted since 1993 and has lost its deterrent effect. We propose to raise the cost ceiling from 5,000 to 25,000. We emphasize that the maximum amount of cost will be reserved for blatant cases of abuse, and the hearing panel of the board will continue to exercise careful discretion in ordering the payment of cost, taking into account the merits of individual cases. Raising the cost ceiling will not discourage those appellants with genuine and reasonable grounds from lodging their appeals. The proposals enhance existing appeal mechanism, and the proposals are supported by the Bills Committee and the Judiciary. I appeal to members to support so that it will be implemented ASAP. I so submit. Thank you. I now propose to question to you, that is, that the Inland Revenue Amendment No. 3, Bill 2015, be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the debate is now adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Members' motions. Two proposed resolutions on